Today we are going to go over some terrific hotkeys and shortcuts that I use quite a bit and will help save you on your video editing time. Before I forget to ask, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button. That way you'll always be the first to know when new, informative, and possibly fun videos have been loaded. I would also suggest adding this video to your Watch Later playlist. To do this, simply click on Add To, then check the Watch Later list. Now you'll have it at your fingertips to refer to when ever needed. Okay, let's get started. As you can see, on the left side of the video, there is a full menu of the hotkeys and shortcuts we will be reviewing. I would suggest watching the video in full, and afterwards you can click on any menu item to refresh your memory on a specific hotkey. So let's start with some of the quick shortcuts I like to use. If you want to add an animation, highlight the clip where you want the animation, click on Z, then double-click on the yellow animation arrow to open the visual properties section. You can now do whatever animation effect you want. For a callout, place the cursor where you want the callout. Click on C to open the callout effects section and make the changes you want to the callout. Some other standard hotkeys used across many software platforms are copy and paste. Control and C for copy and Control and V for paste. If you wanted to cut something and place it somewhere else, it would be Control and X for cut and Control and V for paste. The crop tool, also located in the upper right corner, allows you to crop the video. You see how the boundary lines are white and when you crop they are blue? The shortcut for this is to hold down your Alt key, which turns the lines to blue. Keep the Alt key pressed down while cropping and release when you're done. If you need to extend a frame, what I would do first is use the ripple shortcut to move everything to the right. By doing this, you keep all the callouts, audio, clips together in the same place. Then place the playhead where you want to extend the frame and click on E. You can then choose by how many seconds to extend it and click on OK. You can use the ripple shortcut to move everything back to the left. The hand tool in the upper right corner allows you to move the canvas around. The shortcut for this is to hold down your spacebar to move the video around on the canvas. When you let go of the spacebar, the hand is no longer active. The home key will take you to the beginning of the timeline, and the end key will take you to the end of the timeline. To add a marker, place your playhead where you want the marker and click on M. If you have markers throughout your video and you want to quickly move from one marker to the next or back, hold your control key down and use your right or left bracket key to move from marker to marker. Some shortcuts for moving are if you click in the blank area of the canvas, you can scroll your mouse wheel up or down to zoom in for a closer look or out to see the full picture. If you click in a blank area of your timeline, hold the control key down, then move your mouse wheel up or down, it will increase or decrease the width of your timeline. Rippling is being able to move everything from the playhead to the right or left if you are moving it back after deleting something. Let's say you want to add some space in here and move everything to the right. The easiest way to do that is to put your cursor at the beginning. Hold the shift key down, click on the playhead, and move the playhead to the right. If you want to split a section and move everything to the right, do the same actions. Place your playhead where you want the split to happen, hold the shift key down, click on the playhead, and move the playhead to the right. If you want to have extreme control over making a small selection of your video, hold your shift key down and hold either your right arrow key or your left arrow key down. This will make a selection of the video by steps. This can sometimes be quicker and more exact in selecting exactly what is needed for tiny selections than using the scrub method with the playhead. If you need to undo what you just did or several steps back, simply click on Control and Z to undo as many times as you need. When watching the video, you can stop and start the video by hitting your spacebar. Hit the spacebar once to start and once again to stop. There you have it, the most common hotkeys and shortcuts I use on a regular basis when editing my videos in Camtasia. Now, if you haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the page, and leave a comment below. Let me know if you want more Camtasia training videos like this, or if you have any questions. Thank you so much for watching. As always, this is Naomi with topshelfva.com. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.